Good morning. How are you doing today?
Good morning. How are you?
Absolutely fantastic. I got to tell you, I hope you know inside your heart what you're doing on BET Plus is educating a community that needs to have leadership in why we need to further our education and to keep growing forward.
Most definitely. There's always room to continue to educate ourselves and to continue to grow. And I'm happy that I had the whole HBCU experience, and I'm very grateful for College Hill and Tracy Morgan and BET Plus for engaging me in this whole experience, because it definitely has been an experience that will be unforgettable for sure.
Can we talk about HBCU? There's a lot of listeners that probably don't know what that is, but we have to understand that this is an open door for everybody across this entire nation.
That's right. You know, a historically black university. And I mean, when we got to Texas Southern University, they opened their doors with wide arms and the welcome. You know, they took out the whole band and all of the different departments, you know, the dancers and the flag twirlers, the cheerleaders. And, you know, it was like a big pep rally as a welcome. And you definitely felt the love and the support from the school, all the way down from the president, all the way down to the faculty and staff and the students. And we're very grateful for Texas Southern University.
See, that's so important to have that support like that, because so many people, you know, when they want to further their education, they think it's a solo journey. And it's not a solo journey if you allow other people to step into your world.
Yes. It's definitely a community effort. You know, I'm sorry that Stacey Dash was not able to stick around and get the whole HBCU experience, because she really missed out on a great opportunity and meeting some great people and professors, and, you know, just the whole experience was just unbelievable.
There, you know, we live in this society, and maybe it's because of the COVID lockdown, where it's like, okay, well, I just want to just sit down and let life happen. And that's what I love about what's going on here, Big Frieda, in the way that with Celebrity Student on BET Plus, is that you're saying that, no, it doesn't stop right now. We've got to keep pushing forward as a community and as a leadership.
Most definitely. And even, you know, with COVID happening and all the things that's happening, there's still opportunity for virtual classes online and all of that. So there's no reason not to continue to further your education and continue to want to grow, even if you don't go physically to the school and have to be on campus.
What's so neat about this is that you guys even talk about the internships and stuff like that, because I'm a firm believer in internships, because that's where the experience or the seed is planted. And I love the idea that you guys really, you know, put that out there for people to get the internship, get your foot in that darn door.
Yeah, you got to get your foot wet in order to feel out the whole experience. You want to be engaged. You want to be connected with the people and the experience. So, you know, internship and getting in there and being on ground, on hand, is nothing like it. It's a great experience. You get to meet great people, and you get to have all of these great experiences that you get to learn, you know, hand on hand.
College life as experienced through the eyes of celebrity eyes. I love that statement when it comes to a celebrity student, because, you know, there comes a time for every person that we used to be, but you don't have to used to be, you're going to be, and HBCU opens those doors.
Most definitely. You know, when I went into the experience, I didn't go in as a celebrity. I went in as a student, and that was very important for me, just to go in and get the full experience. I don't want to go in there thinking, oh, just because I'm a celebrity, I want special treatment. I want to have the whole experience. We were in class with, you know, other students, and, you know, we were dealing with professors and advisors, and we got to have the whole experience. We had extracurricular activities and joining clubs. I joined the choir, you know, Slim Thug did SGA, Mimi and Ray J did the debate club, Dream Doll did cheerleading, India did motivational speaking, Stacey Dash did dance, you know, we all have something that we also did on the side besides our, you know, our homework and our schoolwork.
What did you learn in chorus? Because when you said that right away, I had a flashback to high school chorus where they were, you know, we had to learn barbershop and all that kind of stuff. What did you learn?
Well, I mean, I just learned, you know, I had the college experience of being in a choir. You know, I've been in a choir mostly my whole life. I was a choir director. You know, I sung with many choirs in New Orleans. Whoa. I traveled with the choir and sung all around the world. So I just got in where I fit in. You know, that's why I went to the choir, because I'm already experienced in that lane. So it was really easy for me to pick up, and it was great. You know, I was able to connect with the kids and the teacher, and they started to even, like, you know, let me be the choreo captain and, you know, really just get in there and enjoy the whole moment.
Expanding your imagination as well as your drive for success. We live in a world right now where business, it changes and it evolves every single day. When you step out there now after being with HBCU, I mean, my God, your eyes have got to be wide open going, where's the next opportunity?
Oh, most definitely. I mean, it was nothing but black excellence at this whole HBCU. And so definitely it opened me up to want to experience more things and to, you know, put my best foot forward with everything that I do and all of my experiences, especially in the business world. You know, it was a lot of stuff that we could use in our day-to-day lives. And I'm just grateful for those opportunities.
What was one of the greatest challenges? Because, I mean, I love searching for the oh wow moment, because I'll go into Google to look up words just so I can have that feeling of, I didn't know that. I love oh wow moments.
Oh wow moments. I mean, the oh wow moment, I think, for me was, you know, law school. Like, I really enjoyed law school. I was afraid. We all were afraid. Because, you know, we had heard so much about the instructor and how she don't play. and so we were really nervous and we were scared and we were terrified, you know, of this professor. But when we got in there, the lady was so sweet. She really opened our mind up to really have the whole experience. And, you know, I could have went to law school. I went in there and I slayed that class. So, I mean, that was a wow moment for me, not knowing my capabilities in the courtroom.
One of the things, I'm blessed with the opportunity to be an instructor at different universities for future broadcasters and stuff like that. And the one thing that I keep bumping into, Big Frieda, is the fact that people think they're stars right now. How do we work with those that think that success is right now, when you have got to be planted in the soil so that the soil can give to the rest of us?
I mean, those people still have a lot of growing to do. Mm-hmm. Those who think that they're overnight stars. So many of us have been putting in work for many years and still is letting our light shine, you know, day by day, you know, job by job, experience by experience, and just, you know, taking those opportunities and making them grow and the connections and so forth. You know, you have to definitely plant the seed in order for the flower to grow.
Yep.
And you have to water it and nourish it. And it doesn't happen overnight. You know, I've been in this game for over 20 plus years, and it didn't happen overnight. It's still a continued grind. It's still being consistent. It's still being open-minded and working hard. Like, it does not get easier, but you do learn to work smarter and not harder.
You got to come back to this show anytime in the future. The door is always, always, always going to be open for you.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Thank you for inspiring what's going to be happening in the days ahead. You are an inspiration, and I know in your heart you know you're in the right place.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.